The answer is all choices are true except for the first one. The reason the first one's not true is this really doesn't take long to compute. We only need to look at one letter and do a simple modulo computation. That's very efficient. But the other three reasons are true, and we'll go through each of these showing what happens looking at how things evaluate in the Python interpreter. So the first correct reason is that it produces an error for one input keyword. When we write code, we should think about whether it works for all possible inputs. And the one that's usually the trickiest to think about is the boundary case. For a string, that's often the empty string. So if we pass in a string with no characters in it, which is a perfectly valid string, well then when we try to index element 0, that would be an error. So let's see what happens when we try that in the Python shell. So we'll try to evaluate bad hash string, passing in the keyword the empty string, which is a perfectly valid string, and let's say there are 100 buckets. And we do get an error. We get the error that the string index is out of range because we tried to access the character at position 0, but there is no character at position 0 in the empty string. So to understand the other two reasons, I've defined a procedure called test hash function. It takes three inputs. The first input is a function, so we can pass functions around just like any other value. So what we're going to pass in for this is the bad hash string function that we've defined, but we can also use it to test other hash functions, which we'll see later. We're going to pass in a list of keys. Those are the keywords for the hash table. And we're going to pass in the size. This is the number of buckets. What we do in test hash function is we're going to keep results as a list of the number of times each bucket is used. So initially, they're all zeros, and we initialize it with 0 times the size. We're going to use keys used as a list of the keys that have already been used. We don't want to count a duplicate key more than once. So now we're going to loop through the keys. We're going to check if a key was used already. And if the key was not used, then we're going to figure out by calling the hash function where that key would hash to. So if we passed in bad hash string, that would be the function here. And we're calling that passing in the keyword and the number of buckets. We're storing the result in the variable hv. And then we're increasing the value of the element at results position hv by 1. And this is a shorthand syntax, means the same thing as doing a new assignment where we're assigning to results hv the value currently in results hv plus 1. And then we're adding the word that we just used to the list of keys used so we don't use it again. This is similar to what we did in the web crawler to avoid crawling the same page more than once. And at the end, we'll return the results. So what we'll have as the result of test hash function is a list where the values in that list are numbers giving the number of times a key hashes to that bucket. So let's try this with an example using the bad hash string function. So to test our hash function, we need some content. We need content that represents the kind of words that we think we're going to be using the hash table on. I've picked this one, which perhaps is represented, perhaps not. And what's there at that link is Gutenberg's text of The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes. And you can see from the scroll bar, it's quite long. So this is all the text there is, and so on. So we're going to get all the words on this page using getPage. We're going to split them into words like we were doing in the crawler, and we'll store that in the variable words. And the length of that is over 100,000 words. Now, they're not all unique, so the number of entries in our hash table will be smaller than that. But let's see how the distribution is for those words. So we'll use the test hash function that we defined, passing in bad hash string, the words that we got from Sherlock Holmes, and we'll pick, for now, we'll use size 12, definitely too small, but that'll give us a good sense of how the distribution goes for a small number of buckets. So now we have the result. Let's look at what the counts are. And you can see we've got 12 entries, which corresponds to the number of buckets. And they vary quite a bit. The smallest one has only 754 elements. The largest one has over 2,000. So the gap between the smallest and largest is nearly a factor of 3. If our hash function was good, we would want these to be about the same size. Here's what that looks like graphically. We have our 12 buckets. The ones that are red are too full. The ones that are blue are not full enough. We would like this to be a fairly flat graph, distributing all the words evenly between the buckets.